Today on my desk we have the Huawei Mate 8, a smooth looking phone that is quite a bit bigger than my S7 Edge and even dwarfs my Note 5. By this point you probably know what I do with brand new cell phones, so let's get started. Scratch test first. This phone does come with a pre-installed plastic screen protector, so I'll remove that, exposing the Gorilla Glass 4. I have a set of picks with different materials on the tips that let me know where the screen falls on Mohs scale of hardness. Most smartphone screens sit around a level 6. This test will reveal any outliers, like the Droid Turbo 2's shatterproof plastic screen. Like anticipated, the screen did start to scratch at a level 6, and had a much deeper groove with the level 7 pick. Even when the screen is on, the scratches are still visible. It'll be interesting when a phone comes out that can make it past level 6. The camera lens is also made of glass, which is great. It is not plastic like the Sony Z5 Premium or the BlackBerry Priv. The rear button does scratch, but the scratching shouldn't affect the fingerprint scanner ability. The back of this phone is aluminum, so it does scratch when you take a razor to it, but it is pure metal. There is no paint or primer or any other material covering the surface. Your hands are touching good old clean metal. There are plastic tabs at the top and the bottom. These might be covering screw holes or antennas. We'll have to find out when I do my teardown video. The sides of the phone are much thicker aluminum, as you can see here. The phone feels very solid and very heavy, which is fine with me. The more heavy and solid something feels, the more durable it tends to be. The Mate 8 is using something called an IPS-NEO LCD screen. The NEO part means there is no quality loss when you are viewing the screen at an angle. So let's see if this actually does anything. So here's the LG G5, which has a regular non-NEO IPS display. I have both phones' brightness turned up all the way, and I'll tilt them at the same angle to see when we lose visibility on either screen. The LG G5 screen dims as the angle changes, but the Mate 8 does not. The viewing angle is considerably larger with the Mate 8. Usually these terms like NEO are just marketing shenanigans, but in this case, I think the NEO feature is actually pretty cool. Well, let's burn it. The Mate 8 took about 5 seconds for the pixels to heat up and turn off. Still better than the LG G5's 3 seconds, but the iPhone SE sits on the top of the scale with an impressive 16 seconds of flame resistance. Because I know that's the first thing people look for when purchasing a smartphone. Just for kicks and giggles, I burned the back of the aluminum as well for about 15 seconds. Aluminum does not retain heat well, so it was cool to the touch within a second. On to the bin test. I did this test previously on Huawei's budget phone, the Honor 5X, and the 5X passed just fine with only a kink near the power button that I had to bend back into place. Let's see what happens with the Mate 8. When I push from the screen side of the phone, you can see the aluminum frame buckle near the power button just a bit, just like with the Honor 5X, but the phone does not break. Let's flip it around and try it from the other side. Pushing from the rear, you can see some impressive flex, but the phone locks out and will not bend any farther. There is no catastrophic breakage or dovetail joints like with the Huawei Nexus 6P. And this phone is actually bigger than the 6P. The screen can be popped back into the back housing, and the housing bent straight again. Good job on this one, Huawei. If Jerry had a stamp of approval, this phone would get it. My Twitter followers knew the outcome of this test before I posted the video, so if you want to stay ahead of the curve, come follow me at Zach's Jerry Rig. I am also giving away an iPhone SE to one lucky retweeter of this tweet, so go find it in my recent tweets. Thanks a ton for watching. I hope to see you around.